Hello everyone. In today's tutorial, you will learn how to master the Apple Passwords app to secure your logins in easy steps on macOS Sequoia. To store your passwords, passkeys, and verification codes on your Mac, click Spotlight Search, type passwords in the search field, and press Enter on your keyboard. The Passwords app is in your Applications folder. When you open the Passwords app on your Mac, you need to enter the password for your username. Once the Passwords app is open, you can choose a category from the left sidebar to view your passwords. For security reasons, certain parts of the images have been obscured. If you can't see the sidebar, click the sidebar icon to reveal it. Let's go through each category individually so that you can feel confident using the Passwords app. All. This section displays all your passwords and passkeys. In this example, two websites and one app are listed. To view the password for one of these websites, I select it first, and then I can view the credentials such as username, password, verification code, and website address on the right panel. Please note that the verification code is time sensitive. It will expire if you don't use it within the given time. Therefore, you will receive a new one. To copy the verification code, click on it and click Copy Verification Code. To change your password, click the Edit button, enter a new password, next click Save. To delete a password, right-click on it and select Delete. A dialog box will appear. Click the Delete Password button to confirm your action, and it will be removed from the middle pane. The deleted password remains in the deleted section for 30 days until it is removed automatically. To get your password back, right-click on it and select Recover. If you want to import passwords from another app, click the Import Passwords button, then choose your CSV file to import. CSV stands for comma separated value, a plain text format that stores data by separating them with commas. Quotes displays verification codes for you to use on a website. Click on it, select Copy Verification Code, and paste it where required. Verification codes expire after a limited time, so a new one will appear when the old one expires. Security displays passwords that are weak or may have been compromised. Click on the password to view more information in the right pane. From here, you can edit it to make it more secure. Passkeys. This section displays the websites where passkeys are used to log in. Since I don't use passkeys, nothing is listed in this section. Wi-Fi. This section displays the passwords for the networks I have used. The middle pane shows the networks' names. The blue Wi-Fi icon represents the network I am currently connected to, while grayed out icons indicate previously connected networks. To view the password for a network listed in the middle pane, click the network name to access the password. Then hover your pointer over the dots to reveal the password. To copy the password, click on it, then click the Copy Password button. To share a network name and password with a friend or coworker, click the Share button or icon and choose the app you want to use to send it. For example, I choose the Messages app. Enter the recipient's email or phone number and press Enter on my Mac to send the message. If you don't want to connect to a network in the future, click Forget. A message will appear asking, "Are you sure you want to forget this Wi-Fi network?" Click Forget, and the network name will be removed from the list. Deleted. This section displays deleted passwords, which remain for 30 days before being automatically removed. If it hasn't been automatically deleted yet, you can click on it and select Recover. To create a password for an app or a website, go to the File menu and choose New Password, or click the plus button. Enter the name of your app or website, for example, Quick Notes, and enter your username. When you click the password field, the password app suggests two types of passwords, a strong password and one without special characters. If you prefer, you can create your own password, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can also add a short note in the notes field or leave it empty. Finally, click Save. You will get a warning if your password is weak or easy to guess. In that case, click the Edit button, change whatever is necessary to make it secure, and click Save again. If you want to delete a password, click on it and select Delete. You can also arrange your apps or websites by clicking the sort arrows and selecting to sort by title, website, date created, date edited, either in ascending or descending order. From now on, when you access a website, for example, freepik.com, and need to enter your username, password, and 6-digit verification code, Apple Passwords will automatically fill in these fields. For example, when I visit freepik.com, I select my email and click the email field. A key icon appears. If I click the key icon and select Passwords, my email and passwords will be filled in automatically. Here is a troubleshooting tip. If the box for usernames and passwords in Safari settings under the Autofill tab is not checked, the key icon won't appear in the email field. To fix this, make sure the usernames and passwords box is checked in the Autofill tab of Safari settings.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
Alternatively, open System Settings, navigate to General, click on Autofill and Passwords, and ensure that the toggle buttons for Autofill, Passwords, and Passkeys are turned on. This will ensure that the key icon appears in the email field. To add two-factor authentication to your accounts, click the codes and then the plus button. To set up a verification code, you can use a setup key or a QR code image. Let's set up two-factor authentication for a Google account. First, log in to your Google account using your email and password. Click on your account image at the top right and select Manage your Google account. Next, go to the Security section on the left menu. If the menu isn't visible, ensure your window is wide enough. Scroll down until you see the Authenticator button and click on it. Next, click Setup Authenticator. You now have two options. Take a screenshot of the QR image by pressing and holding down Shift plus Command plus 4 and upload it to the Passwords app for verification, or click Can't Scan It. I choose Can't Scan It and copy the key. It's a long series of letters and numbers. Make sure to keep this window open. In the following steps, return to the Passwords app, click Codes, then click the plus button. Next, paste the key into the field and click Use Setup Key. Select your Google account and click Add Verification. If you haven't yet added your Google account login details, click the plus button, then add the website name, username, and password. Next, click Save. Once you click Add Verification code, a six-digit number will appear. Copy the code and return to Google page. Click Next and paste the code and click Verify. The authenticator has now been added to your Google account. From now on, when you use your Google account to log in to a website, click the key icon to enter your username and password automatically. Please note that these steps may vary depending on the service. However, they give you a general idea of how to add a two-factor authenticator to your account. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.